Thank you.
I'm a little hot. Right?
Oh, is it that?
I'm feeling it. I'm feeling a little hot. But I'm going to stay sexy for fashion.
Thank you.
Amazing show. I hope you're happy.
Yes.
You really, you know, it's a lot.
Yes, now I'm a bit better.
Happy?
Yes. Thank you for being
here. Thank you. No, thank you. This is a dream.
Two very powerful women at Chanel. The American rapper Cardi B congratulates Virginie Viard, the new artistic director of the house, after her smashing summer 2020 collection for Chanel. Today we're also with Jenny Kim backstage at the Chanel Fashion Show in the Grand Palais, and we have all the slow-mo you need to see every details. I'm Loïc Prigent, subscribe to my channel for all the fashion drama. Hit the notification bell and comment about Chanel's new ambassadrice, Jenny Kim.
I'm very excited. I really wanted to come to this one, and everyone wanted to go because that's the main thing. Everyone wants to know what's going to happen.
The press is all there. Some of the richest clients on the planet and many stars from everywhere.
I feel very gold today.
Super cool influencer Remki is here, always stylish.
Hi, how are you?
What happened?
I fell the wrong, but it matches my look, so I'm rocking it.
I thought it was Chanel, actually.
Oh, yeah, it is Chanel. I will say it's Chanel.
Jenny Kim is here, fresh from her Coachella triumph. She's one of the diamonds of the Blackpink crown. And of course, I got to talk to the singer slash rapper slash dancer slash model.
What do you think about Chanel?
It's everybody's dream.
Jenny Kim is still shy to this Chanel etiquette. She first goes through the photo call. One shoulder look, she got that French je ne sais quoi, this effortless thing. Many of the French photographers don't know her yet. But as they are polite, they nicely call her Miss. Blackpink in your area, Jenny Kim then walks backstage behind the huge curtain of the Chanel decor, and boom, there she is on the fake rooftops of Paris, the rooftops of the Rue Cambon where Gabrielle Chanel started her empire.
Still trying to figure out what it is.
It's the roof of the Chanel building at Rue Cambon.
So, well, thank you for educating me. For a second I thought it was like New York, you know, roof deck or something, yeah.
It's hot.
Jenny Kim smiles and poses for pictures. And some celebrity fans ask for a click and a clack with French actress Lily Tayeb. Click clack. An autograph. And the princess sits next to the empress of fashion, Dame Anna Wintour, editor-in-chief of American Vogue, art director of all Condé Nast magazines, organizer of the world-famous Met Gala. To keep it cool, Jenny Kim just does what we'd all do. She has a Chanel lipstick pose. Quietly putting the Chanel lipstick back in her Chanel bag in the same color as her Chanel jacket. When nervous, da-da-da-da-da, Chanel lipstick. And suddenly, Cardi B is in the Grand Palais. Clad in full Chanel tweed, total look, reminiscence of what Jacques Debacher liked to wear for his ski holidays. Her stylist is dead serious about Cardi B looking perfect. When Cardi B arrives on the set, she's instantly recognized. Casual chaos, and then Cardi B sits between Anna Wintour and Jenny Kim, an empress, a queen, and a princess. But can we rewatch the fashion chaos just for fun? What is Anna Wintour telling Cardi B?
Hello again. You're leaving your coat behind, that's a good idea. And very big, just like the handbag.
And when the flashes flash again, what does the stylist do? He styles the perfect Cardi B. Everybody is seated, the Chanel show by Virginie Viard can start. The first model out is Maike Inga. short blonde hair, short romper, Maike Inga opens the show as a visual homage to the actress Jean Seberg in the movie Breathless, à bout de souffle, by Jean-Luc Godard. Chanel ambassadress Kristen Stewart has just filmed a biopic about Jean Seberg, and this inspired Virginie Viard a lot.
It's like cute little jumpsuit, kind of boyish but also sweet, and it's very comfy and very Chanel, the fabric and everything, I love it. It's always very special, beautiful moment when you see your look for the first time and you get the makeup and the hair and you see the full look for the show, and it's always very exciting.
The first look was fitted yesterday on the Rue Cambon, and Maike was all too happy.
Oh my god, it's so nice.
The wool Chanel collection is an homage to this moment in French cinema called La Nouvelle Vague, the New Wave, when film directors at the end of the 1950s and beginning of the 1960s tried a more natural cinema, filming without rehearsals or authorizations in the streets, without the big studios, without big teams, just big dreams. Virginie Viard and her teams got inspired by the posters of New Wave movies. Virginie Viard was also inspired by Anna Karina, another Nouvelle Vague actress who was famous for this Paris Match cover with a red camellia in the hair and who nailed this man's hat in Bande à part by Jean-Luc Godard. And look at what is Kaya Gerber wearing, a red camellia on a similar hat. She looks like another Anna Karina. The man's hat is seen on Jean-Paul Belmondo in A Bout de Souffle and on Michel Piccoli in Le Mépris. And here it is again today with a camellia.
I feel very cute in this outfit. I love it. I think it's awesome, yeah.
Is it always a special moment, the fittings in Chanel?
Always, yeah. And always to come back here and see Virginie and Orly and everyone is really special, especially seeing how everyone is staying together. So, yeah, it's really nice to be back.
Thank you.
It's a cinephilic collection, and this black and white tweed is actually a riff on the clapper board used before every shot on the movie set. There are some letters on this number, and Nouvelle Vague King Jean-Luc Godard never resisted to write on his screen. Une femme est une femme, Cosinor présente deux ou trois choses que je sais d'elle. Chanel stripes are a thing, but Breton stripes are also part of the style of the Nouvelle Vague. Jean-Paul Belmondo sports them in Breathless, Jeanne Moreau in Julie Jim, Brigitte Bardot in Le Mépris, in Made in USA, on Anna Karina again in Une femme est une femme, and also in Une femme mariée. And don't forget, Virginie Viard started her career in fashion as a costume designer for cinema. She knows actresses and all the cult actresses of the Nouvelle Vague. Virginie Viard knows her cinémathèque. She knows how to dress a film character to give it personality. Amanda Sanchez, the Chanel in-house model since 2001.
Amanda, c'est votre premier défilé ?
C'est tout premier.
Vous n'avez pas ton badge ?
Ouais. J'ai une new face.
Vous avez toujours le trac ?
Non, une petite adrénaline toujours. Peut-être pas le trac, mais oui, il y a toujours les petits papillons quand même.
Ouais. Vous voyez les gens dans le public ou pas trop ?
Moi, j'aime bien, on peut les regarder, oui. C'est sympa de voir les regards des gens. Je te vois parfois. Je sais que je te regarde parfois.
This white and blue coat made me think of Anna Karina in her white and blue bathrobe in Une femme est une femme. Model Steinberg wears the perfect Anna Karina bob with this grey rooftop sequined Chanel suit. Greys, the grey of Paris, the grey of the street, the grey of the zinc roofs, the grey of the black and white movies. Meja wears this delicate outfit inspired by the pointillist painting of Georges Seurat. The studio erupted in a scream of adoration when it appeared for its final fitting.
Oh, trop
George Seurat's paintings are millions of dots representing the world. And same for this exceptional fabric. It's a plumetis de tweed, a satin-stitched tweed. Actually, all the pink colors are inspired by the pink sunsets of Paris you see from the Chanel rooftops. Can you be sweeter than that? The pink square sequins have been superimposed to look like the images of the film strip, la pellicule de cinéma. Another obvious inspiration is the rooftops of Paris. Again, the rooftops of Paris of the Nouvelle Vague movies, like in Paris nous appartient by Jacques Rivette, or in Le combat dans l'île from Alain Cavalier, or in the fantastic documentary Le joli mai by Chris Marker, or here in Une femme est une femme by Jean-Luc Godard. But also you can guess that Virginie Viard was inspired by the grey rooftops you can see from the windows of the Chanel ateliers and her own Chanel studio. This print is The Roofs of Paris, but it got pleated so everything becomes more abstract. It's the same vertical pleats Jeanne Moreau wears in François Truffaut's Julie Jim. Lots of blacks and reds, which is, I guess, another Nouvelle Vague code. Gigi Hadid, Luna and Grace Elizabeth wearing black short shorts.
You have to pay, you have to... Oh my god, I'm dying! It's fine.
It's good luck if it's Gigi.
It's what do you call it, sabotage.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm so sorry.
It's no problem.
Flowers on the sleeves here are inspired by the flowers you see on the balconies of Paris. And the rooftop print has a nighttime version. Coucou Kanokie!
I love you.
Thank you.
How are you feeling it?
I feel cute and adorable.
You're not afraid of heights?
Oh yeah, I'm afraid of heights. He said don't look down. Look straight. You'll be okay. If I look down, I'm gonna fall.
I thought, let us do it again. Sorry.
The evening numbers are classic Chanel. Variations on black and white, bows, ruffles, mousseline, and origami with Sissy belts as a signature. The last one, worn by Rian Van Rompuy, is a galaxy of lights. Not sure if you're watching the city from the sky or the sky from the city. Singer in France, Angèle, seemed quite happy to have witnessed her first Chanel show.
C'est des vêtements qui sont bien pour la scène, par exemple?
Ouais, bah, il y a du choix. Alors, si je devais choisir pour la scène, je pense que déjà, j'opterais pour les chaussures plates, pour pas me casser les chevilles, quoique c'est pas très haut. Et sinon, j'avoue que j'ai un petit faible pour les jupes, mais sur scène, j'évite, parce que je saute beaucoup. Donc, ce sera plutôt pour quand j'irai faire du jardinage, des choses de la vie de tous les jours, quoi.
Vous avez beaucoup de sacs Chanel?
Non. Oui, c'est vrai. J'ai l'impression d'être une enfant.
But now it's time for a Chanel bag report. Chanel bag report. What were the Chanel bags highlighted in the Rooftop Grand Palais show? Black quilted classic Chanel bag, half moon quilted clutch, white or black, vertical tweed Chanel logo on a vertical mini pillow, and yes, same tweed on the bag as the outfit.
I love that the models walked out with matching tweed bags and the jumpers. Yeah, always the accessories are coveted.
And the bag has the same bread as the trench. A mini Chanel vanity case on the shoulder. A quilted and chain classic, but electric green. The Virginie VR Touch, a silver bag coordinated with the silver of the bread of your Chanel black little jacket. And of course, there were plenty more bags at the fittings, so I guess in the shops too. This was my Chanel bag report! Chanel bag report! Chanel bag! Oh, you look beautiful. Yeah, you only say that to me when I wear my Chanel bag. This was my Chanel report. I hope you felt the freeing sensation of walking on the Paris rooftops. Subscribe to my channel for more fashion and more Chanel exclusives. Hit the notification bell and comment about Princess Jennie Kim and her impeccable pose next to Anna Wintour. And don't hesitate to binge on all my other fashion videos. Bisous! Sadly, Anna Karina passed away a few weeks after this show. You should watch her movies. Her energy is still there, intact. And now, a few minutes of Chanel slow-mo. Pure pleasure.